this slope is 2, negative slope, and up to what value it, the variation is going to be? Up to theta I become pi by 2. So this is the variation of delta with theta I when light ray traveling from denser to rarer medium. Denser to rarer medium. When light ray traveling from denser to rarer medium, variation of deviation angle with angle of incidence is given by this formula. Here it is theta I, and this is pi by 2 minus theta c, it is pi minus 2 theta c. In this case, critical angle, this is the angle of incidence at which the refracted ray is traveling. This is the variation. Now, from here to here, it is a linear variation. From here, it is non-linear variation. For this, expression is delta is sine inverse mu d by mu r sine theta I minus theta I. This is the functional relation for this graph. For this graph, variation of delta is pi minus t 2 theta I. This is the equation representing the graph delta variation. That is how we will be able to calculate. In the exams, they may give you the values like this. They may give you pi by 3. They may ask you to identify these two points and what is the refractive index of the denser medium, relative refractive index. When the graph is given, we must be able to identify that it is corresponding to denser to rarer medium. So this has to be critical angle. This is critical angle is pi by 3 for this given situation. What is critical angle here? Mu denser sin theta c is mu rarer sin theta r, or 90 degree, because at critical angle it has to be 90 degree. Theta c here is 60 degree. Pi by 3 is 60 degree. So therefore, mu d sine 60 degree is mu r sine 90 degree is 1. So therefore, mu d by mu r is equal to 1 by sine 60 degree or 2 by root 3. So mu d into sin theta c is equal to mu r into sin 90 degree, mu rarer medium. So refractive index of denser medium with relative to rarer medium is 2 by root 3 here. That is how we can calculate the relative refractive index. And since it is pi by 3 here, how to identify these two angles? The deviation angle corresponding to this is pi by 2 minus pi theta c. Pi by 2 minus theta c is pi by 2 minus pi by 3. This is going to be pi by 6. Therefore, it has to be pi by 6. How much is this angle? This is delta is pi minus 2 theta c. Pi minus 2 theta c is pi minus 2 theta c, 2 pi by 3. So it is going to be pi by 3. This angle is pi by 3, this angle is pi by 6. So by knowing the graph, by given values, we will be able to determine the refractive index of denser medium with relative to rarer medium, and also these two deviation, corresponding deviations, we can calculate. Problems can be asked like this. Next one, what we Snell's law we wrote, mu of one medium one ray is incident, or incident medium refractive index, and refracted medium refractive index, when I use angle of refraction, this is refracting medium refractive index. Incident medium refractive index if we have, then we can write it as mu I theta I. Theta I is normal here, ray is incident here at this angle. This is angle of incident, normal unit vector of the incident direction. This is normal unit vector, and the ray is bending like this, theta r. This is ER. then we can write this is mu I medium, this is mu R medium, refracting medium and incident medium. Refractive index mu I, sin theta I. Sin theta I can write as E I cross N. What is E I cross N? E I cross N is, whereas E I cross N. E I cross N is 1 and 1. Normal unit vector, this also unit vector. Sin of the angle between these two. Sin of the angle between these two is pi minus theta I. Pi minus theta I. Therefore, it is sin theta I. Sin theta I can be written in terms of unit vectors as E I cross N. Similarly, sin theta R can be written as E R cross N. So therefore, in Snell's law, in this we substitute, when we substitute in Snell's law, refractive index of incident medium in terms of unit vectors as E I cross N is equal to refractive index of refracting medium, second medium, refractive index into sin of R is nothing but E R unit vector cross N. So therefore, Snell's law in terms of unit vector form we can write. This is Snell's law applied in this case in terms of unit vectors. That is the refraction of light here, Snell's law, and deviation produced. Next one is how to construct the image due to refraction. Let us consider a medium, medium 1. Let us consider it as medium 2, and a point object is in the medium at a depth of HO. HO depth, it is object, point object is there. Now how to draw the ray diagram corresponding to the image as seen by the medium 2? Observer is in the medium 2, object is in the medium. How to do it? So rays coming from the object, incident here, go straight without any deviation. So after refraction, they go straight. But rays which are incident on the boundary at some angle, let the angle of incidence be theta I. What happens to this light ray? This may either bend away from the normal, towards normal, depending upon the medium mu 2. Assuming medium mu 2 is rarer medium, means refractive index of 2 is less than 1. What happens to the ray? Ray bends away from the normal. The ray observer looking from here, observer is here, looking at an angle theta r from the normal, will be able to observe this object. This object, rays coming from here, bend like this, but for the observer, rays appear to be coming from this, extrapolation of this, rays appear to be coming from this extension. Therefore, for the observer, object does not appear to be here, object appears to be here. That is what we call it as image of the object as seen by the observer in denser, rarer medium. So it will appear to be closer to the boundary. Let us assume that HI is the height of the image. So as seen from rarer medium, an object in denser medium appears